India, one of the world's fastest growing economies with a population of over 1.3 billion, also has some of the highest figures for people living below the poverty line. Given these circumstances, the government's step to make CSR spending compulsory and accountable will significantly accelerate the country's overall growth trajectory while keeping a close watch on ensuring a more socially inclusive growth pattern. Where once neglected and deprived, now entire societies and communities will benefit from the nation's overall progress. Hello and welcome to Lupin Foundation Presents Enriching Rural India. This special two-part series highlights the holistic and sustainable development model that Lupin Foundation has implemented in various parts of rural India to transform lakhs of lives. On the show today, we are focusing on the Sindhudurg and Pune districts of Maharashtra, where the foundation has done some exemplary work, particularly in areas of women empowerment and skill development. Let's take a look at some of the inspiring stories of positive change from these areas. While this grocery store located on the outskirts of Pune may look ordinary, it isn't the store as much as the people running it who are unique.
We are a group of 5 women. We managed to contribute rupees 10,000 each. Once we had orders, Lupin Foundation funded the group and sanctioned a loan of 11.5 lakhs. We used 1.5 lakhs from the amount to expand our business.
After having secured a loan from their self-help group, Lupin Foundation lent support to the women by training them in record keeping and setting up of systems for running the grocery shop. Similar to the store in Pune, a group of 30 women from Maher Lok Sanchalit Sadhan Kendra is running e-catering service at the Savantwadi railway station. This family travelling on the southbound Konkan route has opted for a unique service that is special to this particular station. They have booked a Malwani meal online on the IRCTC website along with their ticket booking. The project is a part of an income livelihood entrepreneurship development initiative by NABARD.
When decided to start an e-catering service run by self-help groups, the first obstacle was financial support. NABARD came to our rescue and provided us financial support of 6,32,000 rupees. Lupin Foundation and Mahila Arthik Vikas Mahamandal helped us with skill development and training.
These women cook the region's local Malwani cuisine for railway passengers along the south-based routes.
The women who work with e-catering used to cook the local cuisine but did not know how to maintain quality and quantity of the food. Lupin Foundation has trained these women in maintaining quality, hygiene and packaging of the products. The training has helped them in preparing delicious meals and snacks for the railway passengers.
Actually, our vision is that number one, the district should be poverty free, garibi mukt. Number two is rozgar yukt, and third is nari sasakt. As far as the women empowerment is concerned, we formed self-help groups. Through self-help groups, they open their bank accounts in the banks. And through banks, they get finance. Through NABARD, we get finances. So we start this income generation activities. Another most important part is the development of leadership in the women through self-help groups. This is another, which is the hidden, you see, part which is being not noticed. But this is the outcome of this self-help groups. Third thing is that we also provide social security. There are a number of government schemes. So we are linking these women through various social security initiatives.
Lata Malbankar is an expert in cane weaving and making bamboo products.
When I got married, the circumstances were tough as my husband was not employed. At that time, an organization placed an order for cane products. That was when I tried cane weaving and we successfully completed the order.
Snehlata has trained more than 450 women single-handedly.
Lupin Foundation.
It was because of Lupin Foundation's support that we could form our own self-help group, and we received consistent help and support from their end.
She also runs her own cane weaving business and has over 150 women working with her.
If I can provide employment to other women, then I am ready to continue this work. I don't wish to stop at 150 people. In fact, I want to employ 300 to 400 people. It's a dream and I will achieve it.
Apart from providing the training, the foundation also helps secure corporate orders for women who set up their own businesses.
When the women are earning, they are so intelligent, they are so empowered that they know how to access education for their children. They know how to access health for their children. Another area, which is a four-letter word, that is jobs. Skill enhancement is another important area in which we are working. Not only that, we are providing wage employment. We are also exploring new ways and means how the self-employment can be provided. We are providing skills, we are providing finance, we are providing exposure to them. So we are finding and we are searching, we are identifying the new areas and areas where the job exists over there. People should not migrate to the places, and we are also seeing to it that from this lower income level, they go to the higher income level. Not only we are skilling them, we will be reskilling them also.
Well, Lupin Foundation's interventions in Pune and Sindhudurg have helped lakhs of women realize and tap their full potential. Let's head into a short break right now. On the other side, we'll explore some of Lupin Foundation's most impactful skill development initiatives. Stay with us. Welcome back to Lupin Foundation Presents Enriching Rural India. Having the right skill set is essential to entrepreneurship. Today, hundreds of people in rural India are keen to venture out on their own, but they often do not possess the required know-how to start up or scale up a business. In rural Maharashtra, Lupin Foundation is fueling the startup movement by investing time and resources in training people, helping them access the right markets, and often even arranging for capital in many cases. Sharmila Kesavard, a rural entrepreneur, today is a proud owner of a garment shop along with a tailoring unit and a beauty parlor in Ghotawade village.
Haji training me Lupin Foundation karne ghetli ani tithe shilai kaam pan shikli.
Lupin Foundation arranged training for women in our village where I was trained to run the beauty parlor independently. I went on to employ another girl.
Apart from providing training, the foundation also helped her secure a loan from the local self-help group to start and run both her businesses.
माझ्याकडे फक्त शिकलेल्याच मुली नाहीत तर अशिक्षित महिला सुद्धा कामाला आहेत. मी तर प्रत्येक महिलांना सांगेल की गट.
I have employed illiterate women as well. Women should join self-help groups. That's when they realize the strength of unity. They also get to know that they are not restricted to kitchen and kids, but can achieve greater goals in life.
From focusing on skill development to promoting performing arts, with loud makeup, glossy clothes, heavy dialogues, and an attentive audience, Dashavatar is a popular art form and all the characters are performed only by men in temples.
Dashavatar is of immense importance in Sindhudurg and Konkan region.
Lupin Foundation's involvement in preserving and promoting this art and generating employment from it is a step in the right direction, ensuring that future generations taking up the craft not only benefit from it, but also keep it alive for the coming times.
I जे नवीन नवोदित कलाकार असतात त्या नवोदित कलाकारांना लुपिन फाउंडेशनचे जे कोण
लुपिन फाउंडेशन्स ऑफिशियल्स हंट फॉर बडिंग आर्टिस्ट फ्रॉम डिफरंट विलेजेस अँड प्रोव्हाइड देम अ कॉमन प्लॅटफॉर्म वेअर सीनियर आर्टिस्ट कॅन प्रोव्हाइड देम प्रोफेशनल ट्रेनिंग
ते त्या मुलांना
लुपिन फाउंडेशन हॅज प्रोव्हाइडेड अस ग्रेट सपोर्ट टू प्रमोट दिस ट्रेडिशनल आर्ट फॉर्म
फाउंडेशन आम्हाला भरपूर सहकार्य करतं
एज फार एज स्किल डेव्हलपमेंट इज कन्सर्न्ड यू सी ॲट डिफरंट प्लेसेस वी हॅव गॉट डिफरंट मॉडल्स बट वी आर ट्राईंग दॅट ॲट ब्लॉक लेवल वी शूड हॅव अ मल्टी स्किलिंग सेंटर ओवर देअर सो देअर आर डिफरंट वोकेशन्स ओवर देअर द यूथ ऑर द वीमेन दे कॅन कम ओवर देअर अँड दे कॅन चूज अ वोकेशन ऑफ देअर इंटरेस्ट अँड स्किल कॅन बी इम्पार्टेड टू दॅम अँड दे कॅन गो फॉर अ सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट इफ दे गो फॉर अ सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट दॅन वी विल प्रोव्हाइड मायक्रो फायनान्स फॉर दॅम सो दॅट दे कॅन स्टार्ट देअर सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट इफ दे डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू गो फॉर सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट डेफिनेटली वी विल प्रोव्हाइड दॅम जॉब प्लेसमेंट अँड वेज एम्प्लॉयमेंट एज वी आर डूइंग इन भरतपूर सिक्युरिटी गार्ड वी आर प्रोव्हाइडिंग वेज एम्प्लॉयमेंट वी आर प्लेसिंग दॅम इन डिफरंट फॅक्टरीज ओवर देअर इन सिंधुदुर्ग वी आर giving training in hospitality sector and they are being placed in various hotels including Taj.
With its continued approach to develop skill training programs, Lupin Foundation in association with the Sindhudurg Diocesan Development Society has set up a cooking and automobile repair training facility.
We found that since Goa is very close to us, let us start a hotel management course in hospitality. And it is duration is 6 months, that is attending courses and all, and 6 month internship given to them in different hotels in Goa. They have to give their exams afterwards, which is under Skill India and which is registered under MSSDS.
The foundation identifies school dropouts and unemployed youth and imparts training to them so they may take up sustainable livelihood options.
Skill enhancement is the major area in which we are working because unless otherwise youth is being provided skill, then they can have their jobs and they can pursue their their career and their living conditions can be improved and they will be in the growth process of this country.
The power of knowledge can indeed make a person both confident as well as self-dependent. Lupin Foundation's initiatives are bringing about a social change slowly but surely in rural India by empowering people with the right skills. Let's head into another quick break right now. On the other side, we'll be back with some more stories of social change. Stay with us. Welcome back to Lupin Foundation Presents Enriching Rural India. Sustainable livelihood creation for the rural population is one of the major goals of the Lupin Foundation. In Sindhudurg and Pune in Maharashtra, many small businesses are flourishing today thanks to timely interventions by the Lupin Foundation. From skill development to job placement to facilitating small loans for farmers as well as entrepreneurs, the foundation has taken many proactive steps for the financial empowerment of people. The Sindhudurg district in the Konkan region of Maharashtra is famous for its cashew production. However, the potential for cashew processing by small scale and household processors in the region has largely remained untapped due to lack of adequate capital. Helping locals benefit in such a scenario, Lupin Foundation facilitated loans from NABARD to 60 entrepreneurs who have procured processing machines and have set up their own businesses.
We have successfully implemented a cashew processing project under UPNRM in association with Lupin Foundation. We have provided loan to 60 small cashew processing units.
So, unko humne loan Lupin ke madhyam se uplabdh kar diye.
My business expanded after procuring loan from Lupin Foundation. I purchased automatic machines, which also boosted the morale of the employees. Today, I'm absolutely independent.
Apart from helping set up this cottage industry, Lupin Foundation also provided training to small-scale and household cashew processors for yield enhancement and technical support for capacity building.
Lupin Foundation मध्ये मी शिक्षण प्रशिक्षण घेतल्यामुळे मला त्याचा बराच
द ट्रेनिंग दॅट आय रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम लुपिन फाउंडेशन हॅज बेनिफिटेड मी इमेन्सली. टुडे माय प्रोडक्शन हॅज इन्क्रीज्ड.
प्रशिक्षण त्यांनी दिल्यामुळे मला आता जवळजवळ 27 ते 27.5 किलो उतारा येतो.
Apart from creating livelihood opportunities, Lupin Foundation also works towards providing life-giving resources. Access to clean and hygienic drinking water has been a global crisis. 20 kilometers outside of Pune city, the 2,000 plus residents of Nande village have been struggling with their need for safe potable water.
There was a time when the entire village was exposed to grave health risks. Things changed since 2015 when Lupin Foundation installed water ATMs. Now the villagers don't have to face any health threats.
To tackle this situation, Lupin Foundation installed a community-based water purifier. Based on the ATM model, beneficiaries have access to clean drinking water at a nominal cost of 50 paise per liter.
We recharge the ATM card like we charge a cell phone. We only have to display the ATM card to withdraw water from the machine.
Apart from providing access to clean water, Lupin Foundation is also encouraging and promoting the practice of free housing farms or Mukt Sanchar Gotha for villagers with sizable cattle numbers.
Mukt Sanchar Gotha म्हणजे पूर्णपणे जनावरे कमी राहतात, त्यांना कोणत्या बंधारे बांधलं जात नाही.
मुक्त संचार गोता एनेबल्स फ्री मूवमेंट ऑफ एनिमल्स.
पाणी पिऊ शकतात आणि पूर्णपणे जशी पाहिजे तिकडे चारी बाजूला ती पूर्णपणे फिरू शकतात.
The idea being to provide large, hygienic, open spaces where livestock can move about freely, thereby enhancing milk production while reducing manpower requirements.
A farmer can manage 15 to 20 cows in a Mukta Sanchar Gotha.
या पद्धतीने तुम्ही जे जनावर पाळता त्याच्या मागे तुम्हाला जो होणारा फायदा आहे, तर जनावर हे आजारी पडत नाही.
मुक्त संचार गोता प्रोवाइड्स अ हेल्थी एनवायरनमेंट टू द एनिमल्स एंड दे हार्डली फेस एनी हेल्थ इश्यूज.
फुकणे तापेने हे निघून जातात, एक्सरसाइज होती म्हणजे चालतात, त्यांचा व्यायाम होतो पूर्णपणे, त्यामुळे त्यांना ते खालेलं सगळं जे आहे ते पचून जातं.
Konkan region of Maharashtra is home to various species of flora owing to its geography. One such flower indigenous to the region is the surangi.
Surangi is a most important perennial flowering crop of the Western Ghat. Flowering season of this crop and mostly the fruit crops of this region like mango, cashew, it matches. So the insects are attracted toward the flowers of this surangi, which benefits for pollination purpose of the other fruit crops like mango, cashew. So ultimately the yield also increases.
Widely used in the perfume industry, the plant is of significant economic value to its harvesters. But lack of knowledge and research in identifying the flowering plants has proven to be an issue for the local farmers.
When Lupin Foundation, when they are working in the Sindhu district, they come to know that this crop has a tremendous potential and university has to do something with respect to propagation techniques. And that's why it was decided that with collaboration with Lupin Foundation, we'll standardize propagation technique for this multiplication of surangi.
70% of population of this country still lives in the rural areas. Unless otherwise the rural India is lifted, the living condition of rural India is being enhanced, the country cannot progress. And we also see that if the people from the rural areas, if they migrate to the urban areas, the living condition, they are living in the slums areas. And we as a responsible citizen, we as a good citizen, we do not want our population of the rural areas should live in the slums. Therefore, we are creating jobs, we are making a rural India, a better India over here. And now we have also started a process wherein some of the people who are living in the urban areas, they are also migrating back to the rural areas. We have created job opportunities. We have created an infrastructure in the rural areas so that that becomes attractive for them to come back from the urban areas to the rural areas. So our forte and our focus is the rural India.
Well, that brings us to the end of this special two-part series. Lupin Foundation's initiatives are impacting and transforming lakhs of lives every day. And all of these initiatives are scalable, sustainable and replicable in different parts of rural India. They are in fact a testimony to the fact that collaborative efforts, a strong intent and a heart in the right place can indeed lead to large-scale positive change for the underprivileged. Hope you enjoyed the insights. Thanks for joining us. Goodbye.